Hi, everybody. It is Tuesday the 2nd. I'm really looking forward to 3 o'clock is the Clubhouse live stream. And I've missed everybody over these past 2 weeks, so we'll continue where we left off, wherever that was. Really good news today. My brother-in-law is home. They discharged him from the hospital. He'll be in lockdown quarantine for the next couple of weeks at home, but he was in bad shape, and he's come back from it, and I'm so grateful, and thank you, everybody, for all your well wishes for him. So it's kind of like just this heavy weight got lifted, and I'm really, really grateful for the whole family that he's doing okay. It's a gorgeous day out. Of course, they said, maybe expect some rain. It's not a cloud to be seen. It's absolutely perfect. I look out here on the lawn, and there's both the boys are laying there in the middle of the lawn out in the sun, just relaxing. I got a couple of toys around them and guarding them, with really focused on protecting their stuff. But and I just, I've got an interview at 12:30 with Guitar Bass magazine out of Germany. They're doing a bunch of stuff about the immediate family. I was supposed to do them yesterday, and then they had to cancel it. I think things, they were interviewing Waddy and Cooch and stuff, and I think it went longer than expected. And so I said, let's just do it today, because I had another thing I was supposed to be doing after that. So I'm doing that at 12:30. And just got off the phone with Blue, and we're talking about looking at still sorting out distribution for the book in Japan and in Europe, looking at options. It's so frustrating. There are so many people that have expressed interest in getting it, and it's just the delivery costs are really, just crazy. But if I can get somebody to handle distribution in those places, then we can load up some pallets and put them on a boat and get them over. Kind of like I did with the publishing company that was that's in Colorado, where they just flat out bought 1,000 books, and then they're doing it however they want to handle it, which is great. That'll make my life a whole lot easier. The problem with any of that stuff will be they just won't be signed. It'll just be the price of the book without the personalization and all that. But, whatever works. I mean, I wasn't born for retail. I'm living in a world of plan B this year, where plan A just went out the window. And I'm looking forward to plan A coming back in. Doesn't mean plan B will be gone. It'll just mean I'll have more stuff to do that'll be really I'm looking forward to. Take books with me on the road and sell them at the swag counter, hang out after the shows and stuff like that. It'd be fun. I would really enjoy that, meeting people. I just want to see people. I just want to play music for people, see people happy and smiling and gathering. And it will happen. It's just right now is not the time for that. So I was looking at a whole bunch of different music stuff. I was thinking about some more stuff from Bernie Williams, who I loved working with, who was the center fielder for the New York Yankees, and a fabulous guitarist, composer. And I did 2 albums with Bernie, and I was thinking about that. Then I was looking at some stuff I did with Trisha Yearwood, who I really loved working with, and I'll get to her. But as I was with Bernie Williams, I suddenly went, oh yeah, Robbie Williams, I work with Robbie. So I decided to do a tune that I did with Robbie Williams. This was from, I made my notes again. I'm trying to stay on top of this. Robbie was a member of a group called Take That in England. They were like, I think a boy band, one of those successful boy bands. But his real success for him has been when he went solo. And he's gone back to the group a few times and they've done reunions, but I think he's sold 20 million albums or something as a solo artist. So he's had a very successful career at that. But we I went in the studio with him. He was doing an album called Escapeology in 2002. And they brought me in. And then the song I'm going to play for you, it's really cool. It's called Revolution. And the band on this, I mean, it's how we all keep coming together. It's just how everybody's tied together. Grant Geissman on guitar. Now, Grant, I've done tons of stuff with, but Grant was the guitarist on the Van Dyke Parks, Brian Wilson, stuff that I posted yesterday. And Steve Ferroni on drums. And Steve was with Tom Petty for years, played with Clapton. And like a while back, I posted David Gabb, some stuff we did with him, and Steve's the drummer on that. The great Jim Cox on keyboards on this. And when we did our first Immediate Family album, there were some songs we needed keys on and B3 and stuff. And Jim played on that, but Jim's been on half the things I've posted on these videos. He's amazing. And then Waddy's on guitar on this also. And it's great. Eric Marenthal is playing tenor sax, and great Wayne Bergeron is playing trumpet. And the vocals, this is kind of a duet, and it's Robbie Williams and Rose Stone on vocals here. And then there's a full string section on it, really great. And Sid Page, one fabulous violinist, is the concert master on this. There's a lot of names on that, so I didn't get them all down on it. But this is a cool track. It was really fun. The studio we did it in, I forget the name of that studio, but it's gone now. Like so many of the great studios in Los Angeles, they became parking lots and strip malls. And you know, there's none of that kind of love of history. Very few of these places have been, you know, kind of earmarked as having the impact on the industry that they've had. All the fabulous Wally Heider studios that were here, and RCA and Gold Star, all these rooms are just fell by the wayside. It's heartbreaking, at least for guys like me, because we work in them. And there's generations of people that never even knew they existed now that have come along, but from the old fart standpoint, you know, we do miss a lot of those great rooms, and the history that was made in those rooms is incredible. So I'm going to go ahead right now and play this song. It's called Revolution, and this is Robbie Williams featuring Rose Stone. It's a cool track.
Everybody falls sometimes.
You got to be able to do that without a click. I'm just telling you.
I know you're tired.
Just feel it.
When it's time to sleep, you're gone forever.
Make friends with your past, then you can live it at last. Stop crying yourself, walking with the revolution.
You can't keep on keeping on, and everything you lean upon is so bad.
Everybody wants to have their last say. I was just remembering, too, that where we cut that, it's the same room where I did B.B. King's 80th birthday album, where I got to play with Billy Gibbons and Bobby Blue Bland, and it still freaks me out. I'm sitting there, you know, 4 feet from B.B. King and just kind of pinching myself going, B.B. King, my God, it's like, I still have those moments and stuff. So I mean, I still find it just, I really, digging through this whole thing, I think I spoke with my sister yesterday. I forget how many she told me. She said they were checking, and I think I've put up about, I don't know, 430 or something videos since the beginning of the pandemic. And I'll tell you, the thing that's just so fascinating to me, it's just constantly like digging through archives that I never gave a thought to when I was busy working, you know, and finding things like Robbie. I knew I'd worked with him, but I hadn't heard this since we recorded it. And then kind of going, oh, Trisha Yearwood, I really just love working with her. So I think tomorrow I might visit her. But it's just, it's been I'm not an introspective person. To me, everything is all about today and tomorrow, not day before yesterday and back. from there. And that's kind of one of the hard parts that's always happens when you're doing all these interviews all the time, because basically they kind of want to go back to the beginning and go through your career. And to me, my career represents what I'm doing today and tomorrow, not what I've done. That's up to other people to remember, and if they're at all interested. So so it's been a fascinating, you know, year so far, since the pandemic began, of introspection and retrospection about, you know, the different things I've done, who I've been with musically, and the different adventures we've had, and, you know, pulling up stories and moments. So it's been really cool. And on that level, I'm forever grateful that this happened, because I don't know if I would have ever given myself the time to reflect when I was as busy as I've been. But this is a whole cool new little world, and I'm really, really enjoying it. Thing I just realized too, as I was checking my computer, and all the videos are in my computer, and man, my memory is down to nothing in it. So I'm gonna dig around, find, I might have a couple of hundred gig external drives sitting around. I'm gonna start dragging everything off of the computer and just archive it into a couple of different backups and put it away, and I free up my memory, because I'm holding off as long as I can. I have an old MacBook Pro from, like, I think this is from like 2008. I've been nurturing this thing because it has all the ports on it. I can put a DVD in it, a CD in it. It's not like the new ones where you got to buy a whole bunch of extra crap to do all the other things that this one can do all on its own, just so that it can be a little bit lighter and thinner. Who gives a crap? It's sitting on my table here. So I'm gonna empty out as much stuff into external drives as I can today, and open it back up so it'll run a little bit better. And because my internet is complete crap where I am, and I'm always in a challenged mode. I just did FaceTime this morning with Judith Owen. She's still down at their home in New Orleans. And it's got to be really interesting for them, because there is no parade. There's nothing going on, but tons and tons of people have decorated their homes to look like floats. And she said, it's unbelievable down there. It's just fantastic. But you know, they live in the quarter, and the quarter is all based on tourism, and there is no tourism at this point. Everything's pretty well shut down. And so there's death rate is incredibly low from COVID. She said people just come out on their balconies and kind of hang and talk, or they, you know, they, when they're out, they're really practicing distancing and all that. She said out in the suburbs, it's not as bad. I mean, it's bad, but in the quarter itself, she said it wasn't bad. I saw one thing on the news yesterday that I found profoundly distressing, and I hate that this exists in our world, and this is the world we live in, though. But they were talking about the shots being administered, and it said that 60%+ of all the vaccinations thus far in this country have gone to white people. And for blacks, Hispanics, Asians, Native Americans, they're down in the single digit. And I find this just so appalling. This just never ends. And I'm just hoping that they can really get all the communities together, because the death rates are so tragic and so sad. And the idea that so many of these communities are being kind of left behind is really, it just breaks my heart. And I don't want anybody coming on this saying, oh, we knew you'd get into politics. This, I'm not talking about politics. I'm talking about life and humanity. And it's just really sad that so many people are at the bottom of the list for getting taken care of during this period. Because this is the greatest enemy we face on this planet right now is this disease. You know, you sit there and you think of all the incredible nuclear arsenals that all these countries have. And basically, you know, we're being taken down by a microbe It's unbelievable. And so I really hope they can mobilize much better distribution and get people as protected as they can. Because until everybody's protected, we're not really protected. And that's just what I wanted to say today, because I saw this. It was fresh on my mind from the news, and I found it profoundly distressing. And not necessarily unexpected, but distressing. So take good care. I'll see everybody in the clubhouse, hopefully at 3 o'clock today or a little earlier. I love when I get set up with Aaron, and we set up early just so that he can send out the link to the live stream. And then sometimes I'll come early and I hang and I just watch the chat window. And I just so absolutely love watching how everybody talks to each other. And just checking in, how are you doing, how's everything, and having people from everywhere, from New Zealand to Germany to Scandinavia, all over the world come on the chat window, and they've all become a community unto themselves. And I think having created this thing was worth every bit of the effort that's gone into it for this community to have evolved out of it. So I'm forever grateful and thankful for all of you. So take good care, and then I'll see some of you in a few hours. I'm going to get ready now I've got an hour, and then I've got to do my German interview. And the boys are out there now. They start barking. Why, I don't know. A couple of goofballs, though. Okay, I will see you later. Okay, bye-bye.